The lady who was a teacher but who was responsible for the choir was very good in music. And she could hear that there was one voice which is messing everybody up there. Then she called us one by one and said, no, you must just come a queue and all of you do 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 re mi fa so. I arrived there and I said, no, Makubela. No, it's you. Okay, but you can still remain in the choir, but don't sing. Just move your lips. I know you like it. The choir is traveling, is going to places. Just move your lips. You can just be there. I knew I was not a singer. Then I tried athletics. The most fashionable, we all go for what is fashionable. I tried being a sprinter, I was not good. But one day I went out, with friends of mine. We went to jog. It was about a 10, 15 kilometer run. And I was the one who was in front, you know. And I was still going, and I left them. And I never had friends who were my peers ever since, ever. Most of my friends are older than me. And then I could realize that, hey, but I'm good at this thing. Then I went back to school, then I started running long distance. Actually, my scholarship, part of it was an athletic academic scholarship. I think I still hold the South African youth record, if it has not been broken, in 800 meters. I ran a minute and 49 seconds. SA colors. So that's how I discovered. And I only discovered that I could be able to do the 800 and the 1500 meters when I was in, I don't know what you call it now, I was in standard four, which is grade six. That's when I discovered, then I started running. That's how I discovered that I could be able to run. The only way to discover what you were born to do, that's why you discover these things when you are young. You must be actively involved. I remember there was one guy, he would see me do all this. He said, hey, but when I was there, I met him later in life. I met that guy later in life when, and then he said, yeah, no, I want to know well. That's what he said. So you must try everything. If ever there's something at the disposal that you can do, you must try it. Let me share with you one last story before I sit down. I am told, there's a portrait of the Last Supper.
Yes.
Where there's about all the disciples of Jesus Christ and everything. You know how that portrait Da Vinci did it? He went and looked for people who resembled the looks of the disciples themselves. Of course, the disciples were not there. That picture was not that portrait was not painted when the disciples were having supper. It was painted 10 years later. So he went getting Judas, getting John, getting all the disciples of Jesus Christ, assembled them, and he went and looked for somebody who looked like Jesus Christ. And then he drew it. Then there was one person missing, Judas. He could not find Judas. Years later, he met a guy who looked like Judas. He met him in a bar. Then he called him and said, I want to do a portrait. I'm looking for a character. And you look like that person. Then that guy, as they were walking, he said, do you remember me? Then he said, no, I don't. He said, no, you did a portrait of me 2 years ago as Jesus. Because the minute you change or you lose focus or your sense of being or your purpose, even physically you change. You change physically. You know, when you do things that are correct, you follow the right path, even you glow, your skin starts glowing, you become a shining example. Whenever you are becoming a shining, it's not only the works that you do, even your physical stature. When you became Utwamukhaba, you can see that this person is not, there's something that is happening. Mm-hmm. And that is what happens. One last parting shot. You start here. I mean, how do you discover your mission? We preach here, free education, and it's not happening.